are here with Ed Whetstone, and he is going to lay down the fat knowledge. Is that right?
I don't know about fat knowledge. I'm a little sensitive about that,
oh,
you know.
The slim, slender, sleek, better than ever knowledge.
Yes, all of the knowledge.
And so are you speaking today?
No, I'll be doing a masterclass tomorrow.
Oh, okay, great. What is your masterclass about?
It's going to be about procedural texturing in Maya.
Procedural texturing in Maya.
Well, the basic idea is typically an artist has to go in and paint every detail of what a final 3D asset's going to look like. But there are ways to get around that in some cases and use math instead of painting, essentially.
Wow. You're going to be talking to artists about math.
Not much. Okay. What I'm going to be trying to do is sort of take the mathematical concepts, because it's all, most of it's handled behind the scenes anyways. Maya's very smart about handling the math. But some basic arithmetic, a little bit of algebra perhaps. But
algebra, that tends to go a little bit more towards the artsy side, so that's
yeah,
okay.
I mean,
there we go.
It works out pretty well. I mean, so long as you can basically understand how adding, subtracting, multiplying, dividing works, this is stuff that you can do very easily.
All right, and this is going to simplify things, or?
Hopefully.
Right.
That's going to be the aim. We'll see how it goes.
Right. And so can you tell me about where and how you started to get into this whole business?
Well, gosh, ever since I was very young, I saw a movie called The Wizard of Speed and Time by Mike Jitlov. It's a little-known movie, but it's about a guy who does special effects.
Oh, cool.
And he decides to make a movie, and the industry just wasn't ready for him. And the movie is about this one guy trying to make something good and fighting against the studio system and the unions and,
wow,
and everything else that goes into that. The world is such a different place today, but I love that idea of one guy making something, just using the tools that are available to him.
That is cool.
So ever since then, I've known that I've wanted to be in movies in some way or another. So that's just sort of been the trajectory ever since then.
And what have you done within the movies? What movies have you done?
Movies I've done, nothing. Really, I'm only really in my first couple of years in this industry professionally.
Oh, okay. So
I'm
it's
just,
been a hobby up until now?
Well, I've been a student of CG and sort of learning the ropes and trying to get a foot in the door. It's always very difficult. I'm just now starting with the studio that I work for, ReelFX. We're doing our first feature film.
Oh, you're with
ReelFX.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah,
absolutely.
That's where I knew that name from. Yeah.
But yeah, I'm with ReelFX, and we are just now starting on our first feature film.
Nice.
So it's going to be the first film where it's our property, and it's kind of our baby, and we're all, you know, in it together, and it's going to be very interesting to be a part of that process.
That is so cool. Oh yeah. Well, ReelFX is for those of you who don't know, ReelFX is pretty huge in Dallas. It's pretty much the everybody loves you guys.
Well, I mean, if you had told me, even 4 years ago, that there was a studio that size doing that caliber of work in the middle of Dallas, I would have never guessed.
Mm-hmm.
But we are, I mean, when you talk about that central corridor of the United States, we're pretty much the only game in town.
Mm-hmm.
So in terms of those big studios, either Coast or ReelFX is pretty much it.
Right. And so this project that you're working on or about to work on, that's gonna take you for a while.
Well, we have, I think, about a year. My contract is a year for
okay,
this.
Okay, that's pretty short.
I think grand total we have about 8 months to complete it on the lighting side. I work in the lighting department.
Okay, that's what I was going to ask you next.
So,
what do you do?
Mm-hmm. And that's a pretty short schedule for
I
a
know,
feature film.
It's very
and
short.
The last I heard, it's looking like it's going to be at least 80 minutes. So it's a full-length feature film. It's going to be up on big screens. I don't know if we have a distribution deal yet, but I'm sure we will. But it's, our studio has sort of made a name for itself in doing the impossible in terms of turning around a really good product in a really short time frame.
Right. Okay. So you're in lighting.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
I am.
And is this what you've been focusing on since the beginning, or has it changed and
altered? I'm really more of a generalist in the sense of what I'm capable of, but lighting has always spoken to me in a certain way. It's kind of like music in a lot of ways. It's more subtle. It's not something that people notice right away when they're looking at a movie. it has more to do with mood and the way that things feel.
That's so nicely worded.
And if you do your job right, people don't notice it, but they feel it. It kind of skips that cognitive process and goes straight to the emotion part of the brain.
That's really cool.
I find that to be a very engaging process and something that I enjoy a lot.
What were you doing before you did this?
I was a student, pretty much. I came right out of the student UT Dallas.
Oh, okay, great.
I was part of their arts and technology program and applied for the apprenticeship at ReelFX as a generalist.
All right.
And the supervisors over there saw my work and they said, well, maybe we should put him in lighting. I think that would be a better sort of spot for him to be in. So I started out as a lighter as an apprentice there and finished up my 6 months there, and almost immediately they brought me back, and I've got another year contract with them.
That sounds awesome.
Oh, it's fantastic.
Well, I look forward to hearing your talk tomorrow.
Absolutely.
I'll see you then.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.